And that, I think, was one of the messages of our chairman last IBLAC, you know, to propose that Shanghai become the capital of the good consumption for China and for the world. And that's so delighted to see that in 2021 this wish become true. Hello everyone, so my name is Fabrice, and of course I have a Chinese name. What the Chongguan means, Chiao Feibori. I've been here in Shanghai now almost 2 years and a half. This city is a dream city, such a vibrant city, so inspiring city. And me being in the beauty industry, as you know, I see Shanghai a glamorous city, elegant city, super inspiring. So North Asia was created as a zone where there is a lot of commonality in terms of beauty trends, routine and inspiration. And this is what we call the beauty triangle that is formed between China, Japan and Korea. And we have decided to put the headquarters of this zone in Shanghai. This headquarters was chosen because obviously China is our biggest market, bigger potential growth market. But also we see a lot of inflection in terms of trends, and we see China is influencing more and more as well the beauty triangle. We had always, you know, look at China as an inspiration, a place where we can bring the best of the world for China. It was a big success in China and a big success worldwide. Not, it's true that Jean-Paul Agon, our chairman, when I arrived here, he told me, you will see that there is a very particularity in China where authorities will visit you every year and they will ask you, what do you need? And it's true that I discovered this relation that is very a win-win approach. But first, I would like to say that what strikes me the most is that the authorities, they are great listeners. And you know, our chairman is part of the IBLAC. So it's once a year where the municipality and mayor of China spend time with all these worldwide CEOs, part of the IBLAC community, and listen to proposition. And then being able to digest this proposition and concretize some of them to execution. And that, I think, it's a wonderful way to be able to get feedback and actually keep going and making China the lighthouse, you know, of the most modernity, you know, when it comes to business environment, but also when it comes to social evolution. The second thing which comes in my mind is next to the year of 2020, we witnessed a rebound in consumption, and Shanghai decided to take the 5.5 as a big shopping festival. And this year, I've seen the anniversary of the 5.5 become even a bigger event. And it's beyond consumption. We had also the opportunity to advocate with the ecosystem and with the government the good consumption. J'aime Shanghai.
À la Hoshi Shanghai.